I've always been a believer in second chances.
Sometimes we have to hit our rock bottom before we can work our way back up.
When reports surfaced of wild behavior, including underage drinking, Miss USA Tara Connor came close to losing her crown.
I'm an alcoholic addict.
She's agreed to go into rehab. I believe she will be an amazing example.
I'm willing to do whatever it takes.
Tara is going to be given a second chance.
Thank God I have the chance to make it right. And I want to thank Mr. Trump and the Miss Universe organization because their goal is to empower women and to make us the best women that we can possibly be. And I plan on walking out of this the best Miss USA that you've ever seen. It has been the most unforgettable year of my life, and I'm back and better than ever. Soon, I'll be handing over the crown to one lucky lady. Who will win Miss USA 2007? Starts right now.
Tonight, 51 of the country's most beautiful women are getting ready to compete for the dream of a lifetime. The chance to win Miss USA 2007. Gorgeous. Live from the Kodak Theater in Hollywood and Highland, it's Miss USA 2007. Let's meet the 51 lovely contestants.
Rebecca Moore, 19, Vesuvia Hills, Alabama. Blair Chenoweth, 25, Anchorage, Alaska. Courtney Barnes, 19, Mesa, Arizona. Kelly George, 24, Sherwood, Arkansas. Megan Tandy, 21, Fontana, California. Tina Bonella, 21, Grand Junction, Colorado.
P2 standing by. Gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly.
For the day I die, I'm a Texas guy. Melanie Mudry, 26, Farmington, Connecticut. Nicole Basso, 20, Newark, Delaware. Mercedes Lindsay, 26, Washington, District of Columbia.
Jenna Edwards, 25, Miami, Florida.
Brittany Swan, 23, Fayetteville, Georgia.
Chanel Wise, 21, Honolulu, Hawaii. I'm stepping back to the club. It's about an hour I spent online. I just wanted to dance. I went to Jacob an hour after I got my advance. I just wanted to shine.
Mandy Rammel, 21, Rexburg, Idaho. Mia Houston, 25, Chicago, Illinois.
Jamie Stallings, 20, Evansville, Indiana.
Danny Reeves, 21, Hamburg, Iowa.
Kara Gorgeous, 19, Clearwater, Kansas.
Michelle Banter, 24, Louisville, Kentucky.
Gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra
fly.
I'm a Texas guy.
Elizabeth McNulty, 25, Lafayette, Louisiana.
Aaron Good, 21, Fairfield, Maine.
Michelle Holloman, 25. Bowie, Maryland.
Despina Delios, 23, Lynn, Massachusetts.
Kelly Bast, 20, Troy, Michigan.
Paula Lushka, 22, Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Jalen Wood, 25, Waynesboro, Mississippi. Amber Steyer, 20, Orion, Missouri.
Justin Trudeau, 20, St. Ignatius, Montana.
Janice Fulcher, 26, Omaha, Nebraska.
Helen Solis, 21, Las Vegas, Nevada.
Laura Silva, 19, Londonderry, New Hampshire.
Erin Abrahamson, 23, Essex Fells, New Jersey.
Casey Jean Messer, 23, Alamogordo, New Mexico.
Gloria Sofia Almonte, 23, Bronx, New York.
Erin O'Kelly, 21, Asheville, North Carolina.
Rachel Madsen, 25, Fargo, North Dakota.
Anna Malamud, 22, Richmond Heights, Ohio.
Gotta testify, come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'm a Texas guy.
Caitlin Simmons, 21, Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Sharika McKenzie, 23, Portland, Oregon.
Samantha Carey Johnson, 22, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Danielle LaCourse, 21, North Providence, Rhode Island.
Ashley Durham Sace, 20, Newberry, South Carolina.
Susie Heffernan, 20, Brookings, South Dakota.
Gotta testify, come up in the spot, let me extra fly. For the day I die, I'm a Texas guy.
Rachel Smith, 21, Clarksville, Tennessee.
Megan Ellis, 20, Houston, Texas.
Heather Anderson, 26, Sandy, Utah.
Jessica Camoli, 22, Morrisville, Vermont.
Lauren Barnett, 21, Wise, Virginia.
Leilani Jones, 24, Tacoma, Washington.
Casey Montgomery, 23, Petersburg, West Virginia.
Caitlin Morrell, 23, Burlington, Wisconsin.
Robin Johnson, 22, Sheridan, Wyoming.
That's good. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'm a Texas guy.
From Access Hollywood, Nancy O'Dell and Tim Vinson.
Welcome to Miss USA 2007 and hello, Hollywood.
This is an amazing group of women. Not only do we have 51 stunning contestants, but let's add one more gorgeous beauty to the mix. Nancy O'Dell and a baby on the way. Boy or a girl?
Tim, I just had a big burrito for lunch. That's all.
Dear.
I'm just kidding. Of course, you're right. My husband and I are expecting our first baby together. But I am not quite ready to talk about the sex of the baby yet. Yeah, that is.
Well, congratulations, Nancy. You're making history tonight, being the first to ever host this pageant whilst expecting.
I am pregnant and proud, and this little life is the best accomplishment I have ever made.
I hope all the excitement doesn't get things kicking, if you know what I mean. But don't worry, Donald Trump and I have some hot water and towels in the wings if something happens.
Oh, no. All right, Tim, I'm a little more concerned about you and all the excitement being surrounded by all these beauties, because this is your first time hosting Miss USA.
The only thing I can say, this is possibly one of the greatest nights in a man's life. I love the USA.
It is going to be an exciting race here at the Kodak Theatre. 51 young women competing for one big dream.
There's one crown, but there are three rounds of competition. Swimsuits, evening gowns, and the hardest of them all, the final question.
Now, throughout the evening, we are going to take you to a place where no man has ventured until now. The backstage world of Miss USA 2007, but not in the dressing rooms.
Okay. All night, we're going to get in the insider's view of how the ladies prepared for this big event.
This was originally the side of the dress, and now it's mine.
Do you think my butt looks too flat?
Nice. Well, I mean, you could wear the big one if you're up for it.
Do I look good?
You'll just have to stay tuned.
We'll be back with more excitement when the 2007 Miss USA pageant returns live here on NBC. The 2007 Miss USA pageant is sponsored in part by Secret Antiperspirant. Secret, strong enough for a woman.
Welcome back to the 2007 Miss USA pageant. Is everyone ready for an incredible evening?
Okay, well, we might as well get it all out in the open right now. What a year it has been for the Miss Universe organization. The unexpected story of the reigning Miss USA, Tara Conner, has been all over the news for months.
I don't think there has been a story like this ever in the history of Miss USA.
And you know, there is a saying when we are about to announce the winner, if for some reason the current Miss USA cannot fulfill her duties, then the first runner-up takes over. Well, many thought that that was about to happen, but there were some major surprises, and everyone was waiting to find out what was going to take place.
Before we talk to the courageous title holder, let's take a look back at her truly unforgettable year. It all began last April in Baltimore, Maryland, as millions watched 20-year-old Tara Conner capture the crown.
So Miss USA 2006 is Kentucky!
Making her the first woman from Kentucky ever to win the title Miss USA. Tara's whirlwind adventure began with non-stop excitement as she was whisked off to New York City to start her new life in the limelight. Her schedule was jam-packed with personal appearances, photo shoots, and even a guest spot on Bravo's Project Runway. Tara also competed in the 2006 Miss Universe pageant, where she made it to the top five. Throughout her year, Tara traveled the nation as a champion for various charities and spent time with the USO, supporting US servicemen and women. On the surface, it seemed to be going well, but the glare of the spotlight seemed to ignite a problem Tara had been secretly struggling with for some time. Then, in an unforgettable press conference, Donald Trump announced that instead of stripping Tara of her title, he would be sending her to address her addiction. Now Tara serves as a glowing example and courageous role model for young women everywhere. As one of the most remarkable stories in the 56 years of Miss USA, Tara Conner is living proof that there are second chances, and with hard work and determination, anything is possible. Ladies and gentlemen, the reigning Miss USA 2006, Tara Conner.
Hello, Miss Tara.
Tara, I was actually there at that press conference. A lot of people would have assumed that the decision had already been made, but tell us what actually went on.
I went up to Mr. Trump's office, had a sit down with him, because pretty much everyone had
given up. You know, they were fed up. And so he saw something in me that everyone else didn't. I got a second chance, and here I am.
You know, I know it was painful while you were going through it all. Give her a round of applause, yes. Now looking back upon it all, how has it changed you as a person, and what do you think you learned from the whole experience?
You know what, the great, amazing thing is I'm actually capable of feeling this moment right now, where before I'd suppressed my emotions for so long, I couldn't feel. And now I can live life positively, and I can be outgoing, and I can move forward, and I can grow, and then I can use my experience to help others.
Well, we hear there are very exciting things on the horizon for you. Can you fill us in on what might be happening?
Well, I plan on writing a book in about a year and a half. That's my first goal. I'll be doing a little bit of correspondent work and a little bit of acting here and there.
You could be busy.
She's taking her job.
She's got the looks.
Yeah, she definitely does. Tara, good luck to you. We wish you the best.
Well, tonight's pageant will be filled with moments of high drama, lots of ups and downs, and we're ready to start right now with our very first cut.
Now, to all the ladies, we certainly wish you the very best. And remember, if you don't hear your state being called, well, you did a wonderful job to get this far.
And for those of you who did make it, remember, this is the easy part.
Now, prior to our show, a separate panel of judges viewed all the contestants in a preliminary competition. Their votes, along with members of the Miss Universe organization, determined who would make tonight's first cut.
And so, here are this year's top 15 in random order.
First up, Virginia!
Take your mark, Rhode Island!
It is time for South Carolina.
Welcome, Utah.
We are calling Hawaii.
Step up to the plate, Texas.
Moving forward with Kansas.
You were chosen, Missouri.
Down California.
In the 10th spot, Nevada.
It is your turn, Michigan!
This moment belongs to Louisiana!
Three more to go, and North Carolina, you're one of them.
Here she comes, Tennessee.
And the final slot goes to Wisconsin.
Well, there they are, the top 15, all wearing original fashions provided by Tadashi.
Let's share this backstage moment as we catch the ladies reacting to the first cut. Coming up, a swimsuit competition that will dazzle your senses. Plus, meet the panel of celebrity judges who will determine this year's winner. It's all happening when Miss USA 2007 returns live from Hollywood here on NBC.
Have fun. Okay, let's go. Swimsuit.
Welcome back to Miss USA 2007, coming to you live from Hollywood, California.
The thought of winning the title of Miss USA is a once-in-a-lifetime dream come true for one lucky young lady.
Now, a lot of incredible things happen when you win the crown, and one thing you have to be prepared for is that as the title holder, you will be photographed a lot.
It's true. Everyone from over-enthusiastic fans to top fashion photographers will want to snap your photo.
All 51 contestants had a chance to find out what it's like to be a part of a real professional fashion shoot. And guess what? You are invited to see what exactly went on.
The man behind the lens is famed international fashion photographer Fadil Barisha. Here now is an exclusive look into the 2007 Miss USA fashion shoot.
Virginia.
Rhode Island.
South Carolina.
Utah.
Hawaii.
Texas.
Kansas.
Missouri.
California.
Nevada.
Michigan.
Louisiana.
North Carolina.
Mm-hmm. Tennessee.
Wisconsin.
The cameras never lie. These women are absolutely stunning.
Are you on overload yet, Tim?
I'm pacing myself. The night's just begun, Nancy.
You know, my advice for the rookies is just breathe. Breathe deeply.
Breathe in and breathe out.
There you go.
Probably a tip you could take up in a couple of months.
That's probably very true. Just who will win tonight's pageant? Well, that is the big question. And the only people who know that answer are the all-knowing, all-powerful, and all-celebrity panel of judges. So let's meet them.
Former Miss Teen USA and host of MTV's Total Request Live, Vanessa Minnillo.
The new host for the second season of NBC's hit show America's Got Talent, Jerry Springer.
Model, entrepreneur, designer, author, and special correspondent for The Insider, Kimora Lee Simmons.
Starring quarterback for the NFL's Tennessee Titans, Vince Young.
E! News anchor and author of How to Think Like a Guy, Juliana DePandy.
Star of the hit Bravo reality series Blowout, hairstylist Jonathan Anton.
President of one of the world's top modeling agencies, Trump Model Management, Corrine Nicholas.
And owner of the 8-time NBA world champion Los Angeles Lakers, Dr. Jerry Buss.
Well, thank you, judges, and no peeking at each other's monitors.
Well, the competition is about to heat up, and when we return, we're taking it all off and putting on the swimsuits, the girls, that is, the contestants. Yes.
Backstage, the contestants are busy getting ready for the next round of competition. When we return, it will be hotter than a day at the beach. We've got the sizzling swimsuit competition when the 2007 Miss USA pageant returns live here on NBC.
You good?
We are back live at the Kodak Theater in Hollywood, California, where Miss USA 2007 is in full swing.
Now, if you spend any time around the contestants, you'll notice them doing a lot of sit-ups, pull-ups, and bench dips around the clock.
And we're talking about in hotel hallways, on the bus, backstage, on stage, practically everywhere.
Now, I would do that, too, if I had to walk around in just my swimsuit.
Yeah, and don't forget that you'd be wearing high heels, too.
Nancy, I wore them once, and it was at a party.
Tim, keep your personal life personal, okay? Anyway, the judges are looking for the ladies with the most confidence, poise, and fitness.
Your job is to sit back and enjoy. And my job is to act like it's every day I get to see 51 beautiful women walk around in their swimsuits.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Miss USA 2007 Swimsuit Parade.
Begin the Miss USA 2007 swimsuit competition with Virginia.
Rhode Island.
South Carolina.
Utah.
California.
Nevada.
Michigan.
Louisiana.
Yeah. North Carolina.
Tennessee.
Wisconsin. Stunning in their swimsuits, but which ones will make the top 10?
Well, the judges are punching in their results, and the minute we come back, we will reveal their choices.
Viewers at home, start making your predictions.
We're making big dreams come true here tonight. Find out just who will make the top 10 and be that much closer to winning the title Miss USA 2007. It's all happening when we return live here on NBC.
We're back at the 2007 Miss USA pageant. How are the two of you doing?
We're doing great, Tim. Thank you very much. But I have to admit, it's hard not to feel all the nervous energy that's going on the stage right now.
Well, that's because only 10 of these young ladies get to advance to the next round of the competition.
Now, ladies, if you don't make it, it is important to remember to be gracious, graceful, and classy no matter what. No mud wrestling or anything like that.
Shame. But if you want to scream or protest or make a big scene, we'll be here watching too.
The judges made their decisions. The results are in, and these are the top 10 contestants of Miss USA 2007, once again, in random order.
Okay, we begin with Virginia. Lauren Elizabeth Burnett has served on the Anti-Tobacco Advisory Board in her state. She is currently a student at Virginia Tech.
Two for two with Hawaii. Chanel Wise calls herself dedicated, loyal, and down to earth. In her free time, she enjoys Polynesian dancing.
Calling Missouri. Amber Marie Sire calls herself a good listener. Despite a busy schedule, she managed to maintain a 4.0 GPA in college.
Now it is time for Texas. Megan Ellis is a communications and Spanish major. She was recently offered a job as a nutritionist.
Spotlight on Tennessee. Rachel Smith was the managing editor of her university's newspaper. She dreams of a career in journalism.
Five to go now. Nevada, you're one. Ellen Salas attends the University of Nevada and studies broadcast journalism. She is also a professional model.
We are traveling with California. Megan Yvonne Tandy is an actress, model, and beauty consultant. She presently studies business administration.
It is your turn, Kansas. Kara Renee Gorgeous participates in track and field and currently studies political science and history.
Join us, Utah. Heather Anderson studies social sciences at Utah State University. She loves to sing and watch football.
And in the 10th and final spot, Rhode Island. Danielle, of course, enjoys creative writing. She says it provides a chance for personal expression.
Well, there they are, the top 10 finalists of the 2007 Miss USA pageant. Congratulations, girls.
Well, now that we know who made the top 10, it is time to go beyond just the pretty faces.
Now, if you're campaigning to win a title as important as Miss USA 2007, you have to let the people know a little bit more about who you really are.
So now, here are this year's top 10 revealing their inner beauty.
Most people don't know that I'm extremely athletic. I was actually a three-star athlete in high school, basketball, volleyball, and track. I was actually voted best looking in high school. How convenient, here I am. So thank you, JJ Kelly High School. Go Virginia!
I'm a very giving person, and I want my inner beauty to shine, and God, you know, shining through me as well. And I think I'm a unique, different person, and it's been about 10 years since Hawaii was, you know, crowned last, and she did become Miss Universe, and I think it's time for a new one.
I like to think I'm a pretty appreciative person, but there is a lot that I expect, and sometimes I take a lot of things for granted. Life in general is just something to be passionate about. Mr. Trump, if Miss USA doesn't work out, hopefully I can find a spot on The Apprentice.
I'm the director for Childhood Obesity and the Get Tough Project. And we've been able to go into schools and teach the children good and healthy eating and exercise habits. And it's very rewarding when you see kids actually excited about being physically fit.
Oh, I'm so passionate about education, volunteering. I see myself having my own philanthropic organization to give back and to make sure that children in impoverished areas are getting the education that they need.
And I'm passionate about life, too. I'm very passionate about life, like waking up every single day and, you know, enjoying being here and being in the moment. And every moment, I enjoy it. I'm just happy to be alive and healthy.
The most influential people in my life are my parents. My parents are just so lovely. They've been together for 29 years, and just their commitment to one another and their positive energy and how they've helped me literally through everything. They are absolutely great.
I've been active ever since I was younger. My parents never pressured us to do athletics. We just naturally want to. It's a great way to expel extra energy. It really helps shape who I am, and it's a really good time for me to be by myself.
I am passionate about the DARE program. I lost a brother to an accidental drug overdose, and I've spent the last year of my life pretty much devoting it to teaching kids the dangers of substance abuse. So that's what I do as Miss Utah, and what I will continue to do for the rest of my life.
Volunteering and giving people, you know, positive thoughts and attitudes helps them in their recovery from the hospital. So I volunteered with different hospitals in Rhode Island looking for what I wanted to do later in life. I fell in love with nursing anesthesiology.
Great group of contestants. Now is the time when we are really narrowing down our favourites. I know I've got one, but I can't tell you who it is. But that's what makes this pageant so much fun.
The 2007 Miss USA Pageant will return live here on NBC.
Welcome back live to Miss USA 2007.
I have to say, Nancy, you look absolutely ravishing.
Thank you very much, Tim. I thought I'd change it up a little bit since we've arrived at round two of the competition, the evening gowns.
Question, how do these contestants prepare for something like this? Is it simply just picking a frock and putting it on?
No, there's like a whole science to it, Tim. It's like you have to find the right gown, the right high heels, then you have to break in those high heels, and then you have to practice walking around in the heels.
You keep bringing up those heels. It was once...
I told you to keep your personal life personal. Well, the judges are looking for poise, elegance, charm, and that extra special something.
So let's see who's got that special something. Ladies and gentlemen, the Miss USA 2007 Evening Gown Parade. In the evening gown competition with Virginia.
Hawaii.
Missouri.
Texas.
Someone gotta give enough letters to support your shoe. Bet it's lifestyle, so rich and famous, Robin Leach.
So get jealous, half a million for the stove. Taking trips from here to Rome. So if you ain't got no money to.
Tennessee. California.
Thank you.
There they are, the evening gown competition top 10. Absolutely lovely, ladies. Now the judges are busy at work trying to figure out which one of these beautiful young women will advance to the top 5. It is going to be a close race, as you can tell. And Tim is with our judges right now to get their reaction so far. Tim.
I am indeed, Nancy. Now, you've been up here before. You've seen what the girls do. What's going through their minds at the moment, Vanessa?
Right now? You know, all the hard work is paying off. So I think you just got to remember to have fun and try to be yourself as much as you can so that we can see that. But I want to know how Nancy is walking in 5-inch high heels.
I taught her how to do it.
I think she's my hero right now.
Jerry, you're a lucky guy. You've got a bird's eye view here. You've seen everything on television. Where does this pageant rate on memorable moments?
Well, for me, this is near the top because I've been doing my TV show for 16 years and I never knew women had teeth. this is unbelievable. I'm just looking at their smiles. It's wonderful. No, this is a lot of fun.
And the caliber's very high.
Yes, my pacemaker's going crazy.
And Kimora, just a quick thumbs up or down. Are you enjoying it? Thumbs up from Kimora. Well, the judges certainly have their work cut out for them because soon they're going to narrow the competition down to the top 5. It's about to happen, so stay with us.
Next up, the winners of Miss Congeniality and Most Photogenic. Then, who will make the top 5 and get to compete for the title Miss USA 2007? Find out when we return live here on NBC. Welcome back to Miss USA 2007. Now, one of the big questions in the pageant world is, what is your beauty secret?
You must never ask. One thing I've learned here tonight is that it's a woman's prerogative to keep all her beauty secrets to herself.
All right, thanks for the tip, Tim. I will never ask again.
Well, on the other hand, I'm always looking to discover some new styling and hair products. So ladies, if you want to chat after the show, I'm available.
I told you, I said never to ask, or you told me that.
Yeah, no, they're getting tips from me.
Oh, that clarifies it. All right, well, no beauty secrets revealed right here on stage, but we did manage to catch up with the ladies who shared some interesting confessions with us.
I see fear in your eyes. You're trying to represent your state. You're trying to be glamorous. It's a very difficult thing.
I can mess up as much as I want for the first week, and then by the second week, if I don't have it, then I can start worrying.
There's a lot riding on this, trust me, I know that.
It's only the third day and there are blisters everywhere.
It just hurt my tooth, but I'm good now.
Acne in the face. Right across my lip is swollen, my eye can't see out of it.
Remember, the camera is, you never know when the camera's hitting you.
Hi.
There's something in my teeth.
Oh man, it really is obvious. The camera, you can't hide anything from the camera.
And let's not shoot this right now, okay?
Oh my God, stop following me! Every time I say something dumb, I see that all the little red lights on. Yes!
Be careful what you say on camera, please.
My roommate.
Oh. She poops a lot.
No, I'm kidding.
She doesn't tell her I said that.
I love everybody equally.
No, I don't. All bets are off.
If I find out that she's trying to sabotage my chances,
I'd probably tie her up in the locker in the bathroom.
She threw chocolate syrup all over my white dress.
I think if I fall asleep, she's gonna cut it to shreds.
I'm out for blood.
I don't think there's one girl that, is better than me.
I am the next Miss USA.
No, you're not. I am the next Miss USA.
Whatever.
The Kodak Theatre has been home to many of Hollywood's top awards ceremonies, and right now it can add 2 more honors to its prestigious legacy.
prestigious. Love it. Whoever wins will receive a Rogasca Crystal Trophy.
First up, the famous Miss Congeniality.
Now, this award is particularly special since it is voted on by all 51 contestants.
Does that mean you can vote for yourself?
Well, it does, if you consider yourself to be charming, friendly, funny, and easy to hang out with, but you can't vote for yourself, Tim.
The ladies voted and chose as their own Miss Congeniality, Montana. Next, is it possible to be picture perfect? Well, according to the American public, yes. You, the viewers, went online to NBC.com where you surveyed all 51 beautiful faces.
Let's see who you picked. And it was one of the closest races ever, and she won by less than 1%. Miss Photogenic, Alabama.
Congratulations. We're about to go for broke, meaning winner takes all, including the title and the crown.
Not so fast. First, we have to narrow the playing field to the top five.
Seems impossible. I would not want to be the judges right now. They all seem so deserving to me.
Well, it is about to happen when Miss USA 2007 continues live right here on NBC.
The official Mikimoto crown, valued at $200,000. Features 117 Japanese Akoya and White Sea cultured pearls and 482 diamonds totaling over 11 carats.
We are back live at Miss USA 2007, where the women are gorgeous, the competition is outstanding, and the stakes are very, very high.
There is one crown and 10 ladies who want it very, very badly.
But guess what? In a matter of seconds, we hate to say it, but only five will have the chance.
The judges have cast their votes, and we've got their verdicts hot off the press.
Here now are the top five finalists, once again, in random order.
First, Nevada.
Now we are calling Tennessee.
Join us, Kansas.
Next we have Rhode Island.
And rounding out the top five is California.
There they are, the top five. Congratulations, ladies.
After all these rounds of competition, let's take a moment to relax and break the ice with some friendly conversation, Nancy.
Now, remember, one of these ladies right here will be the very next Miss USA. It's getting to the exciting part.
Let's begin with Nevada. Here she comes. Can you tell us about your experience on the coldest night of the year in Minnesota?
Well, coming from Las Vegas, it's very hot, so me and my friends were going down to Minnesota, and I didn't have the proper attire, and my friends had a great idea to go to the Winter Carnival Ice Castle, and it's about 25 below zero with a 50 below windshield. I absolutely froze. And they saw our crowns and sashes as we got out of the car, and they're like, oh, come in, come in. I said, okay, okay. And they let us sit on the throne of ice, and I felt like a queen, but a frozen queen.
Glad you survived. Thank you very much, Nevada.
Thank you very much. Tennessee, come on over. Tennessee,
hi.
Tell us about the volunteer work that you did in South Africa.
Oh, it was amazing. In the month of January of 2007, I had the opportunity to volunteer at the Oprah Winfrey Leadership Academy of South Africa for girls. And it was absolutely incredible. 11 different languages are spoken in South Africa, and many of the girls, the 151 girls that are there at the academy, speak 4 or 5 of these South African languages. And it was amazing and really sparked my interest in helping impoverished individuals, especially children. So hopefully someday I'll get to go back.
Tennessee, thank you very much.
Join us, Kansas. Hello. Now, you've done a great deal of volunteer work. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
All of my volunteer work?
Just a little resume.
I'm a talker. That might be a really long story. But most of my volunteer work that I did was with my Catholic youth organization, and it was fantastic. So obviously we did a lot of things with, we worked with abortion centers and medical centers, and we adopted a family, and you know, we worked with Venezuelan missions, you know, just all kinds of things to help put our love out there for everybody.
Well, I'm glad you got time to fit us in. Thank you very much, Kansas.
Thank you, Kansas. Come on over, Rhode Island. Rhode Island, we hear that you enjoy reading and creative writing. What is it about that you enjoy so much?
Well, being a little girl, my mother always instilled in me the importance of learning and education, so it also gave me an opportunity to release my feelings, and it was kind of a therapeutic experience, so I still do that to this day, and I keep a journal.
Rhode Island, thank you very much.
And now, California. One or two fans here. Can you tell us about the sleepwalking incident that happened recently?
Oh, okay. Well, unfortunately, I didn't get any sleep at the state pageant for Miss California USA, and unfortunately, I woke up in the middle of the night, and I woke up my roommate, and I shook her awake, and I felt really bad because she was trying to get her sleep, but I don't know. I was just really, really exhausted, so.
Well, you look like you've had plenty of sleep last night.
Not really. I'm probably sleepwalking now.
Thank you very much, California. We'll wake you up.
Well, best of luck to all of you ladies. A fabulous job. And the final question is next, the really nerve-wracking part. So everybody, get ready. The final question is next, and anything can happen. Stay with us as Miss USA 2007 continues live here on NBC.
Welcome back to the 2007 Miss USA pageant. These beautiful young women have managed to land a spot among the 5 finalists.
Now, this was no easy feat. Think about it. They had to look amazing in a swimsuit, positively breathtaking in their evening gowns, and now they have to win over the judges with their ability to answer a thought-provoking final question in front of millions of people.
You're making me feel nervous. We call this part Grace Under Extreme Pressure.
Now, this is the round that determines everything. So, ladies, try to be calm. Judges, we ask you to be fair. And, Tim, remember, again, breathe.
Breathe in, breathe out. Thanks, Nancy. This year, our panel of judges selected their own question, so now we will ask each of our finalists to pick the name of the judge and their final question.
Ladies, you will have 30 seconds before you hear this bell. Nevada, come on over here. Pick out the name of a judge and hand it over to me. This comes from judge number 6, Jonathan Anton. Who is your hero and why?
My brother is my hero. He was in the United States Air Force, and I just look up to him. Always as a little girl, I always looked up to him. I'm very proud to this day that I had my brother, and I would not change that.
Nevada, thank you very much.
Thank you, Nevada. Next, Tennessee, please pick out your judge. This is from Vince Young. If you could be famous man for one day, who would you be and why? Famous man.
I would have to say Will Smith. He just comes to mind. I love his humor. I love his character, his integrity, the roles he takes on in his acting career. I think he's a great man, a great family man, and someday I'll strive for that as well. Family woman, that is. But, yeah, great guy.
Thank you very much, Will.
All right, Kansas, come on over. Your turn. Grab a good one. This comes from judge number one, the beautiful Vanessa Manillo. Do you think everyone deserves a second chance in life, no matter what they have done?
No, I don't think everybody deserves a second chance. I think second chances are very situational. Sometimes they're deserved, and sometimes they're not. If someone can change their attitude, if a second chance is going to improve this person's life, then of course they should be given a second chance. But in situations such as murder, second chances obviously should not be granted.
Kansas, thank you very much.
Next, Rhode Island. Please pick out the name of your judge. This question is from Jerry Springer. I'm worried. If you had the power to ban the use of something, what would you ban and why?
If I had the power to ban the use of something, it might be using cell phones while driving. I know personally in my state it's a big issue, and I know they just banned it in New York, but I mean, a lot of people run, you know, others off the road while on the phone, being distracted. I mean, I see people shaving in the car, so banning the use of cell phones would definitely be my answer.
Thank you very much. I've stopped shaving my legs in the car.
California, come on over. Grab one out of there and make it a good one. This comes from judge number five, Juliana DePandy. Is it ever fair for a woman to use her beauty to get ahead? If so, when?
I think it's okay. I think it's appropriate in some cases. I think it's very important that we are also beautiful, not only on the outside, but on the inside. And I think that it can go to different measures, and it doesn't matter if you're beautiful, just as long as you're pretty on the inside.
California, thank you very much.
Well, all the ladies did a great job. Congratulations, and once again, good luck.
Winning the title of Miss USA 2007 is a huge honor and the opportunity of a lifetime.
As a little added bonus, the winner gets to walk away with a prize package that would give anyone incentive to look good in a swimsuit. This too can be yours, that is, if you win the pageant.
Tonight's winner will begin her year as Miss USA 2007 wearing the official Mikimoto Culture Pearl and Diamond Crown. She'll also receive an exquisite Culture Pearl tiara. Mikimoto, the originator of Culture Pearl since 1893 and the official jeweler of Miss USA 2007. During her reign, the new Miss USA will enjoy a luxury New York City apartment, a personal appearance wardrobe, and professional representation by the Miss Universe organization. Our new Miss USA will receive a year of modeling representation with world-renowned Trump Model Management. And to help keep her on time for her many appearances, Miss USA 2007 will win a Rita Mundo timepiece valued at $35,000. To keep her looking fabulous, the new Miss USA will receive a custom-designed personal appearance wardrobe from Tadashi. Tadashi, the official fashions of Miss USA 2007. And to make a splash, she will receive a swimsuit wardrobe from BSC Swimwear Thailand. BSC Swimwear Thailand, the official swimsuits of Miss USA 2007. Tonight's big winner will also find herself enjoying a brand new shoe wardrobe from Nina Shoes, the official footwear of Miss USA 2007. For incredible hair, our new title holder will receive a one-year supply of Farouk Systems products, maker of Qi, the original ceramic technology tools, and hair care that produces shine from the inside out. From YMI Jeanswear, the new Miss USA will receive a denim wardrobe and will be featured in a worldwide advertising campaign. YMI Jeanswear, the official denim of Miss USA 2007. Now that she's ready for the spotlight, the New York Film Academy will award our winner a scholarship to its two-year acting or filmmaking programs worth up to $100,000. And to get away from it all, our shining star will experience a four-day, three-night trip for two at an American Airlines destination in the Caribbean or Mexico. All this, plus memories, last a lifetime.
As the judges cast their final vote, let's take one more look at the top five contestants of Miss USA 2007. One of these girls is minutes away from starting the most amazing year of her life. We begin with Nevada. Tennessee. Kansas. Island. California. Are the five beautiful finalists. Take a look, because one of them will soon be crowned the new Miss USA 2007. We are moments away from the big decision. And we'll find out who wins the crown when we return live from Hollywood, California, here on NBC.
The 2007 Miss USA pageant is sponsored in part by Pampers. Inspired by babies. Created by Pampers.
Well, if you think you have what it takes to become the next Miss USA, log on to NBC.com to find out more.
We want to take this moment to give a big thank you to the people of Hollywood.
And to our terrific judges.
Vanessa Manillo.
Jared Springer.
Kimora Lee Simmons.
Vince Young.
Juliana DePandy.
Jonathan Anton.
Kareen Nicholas.
Dr. Jerry Buss.
And of course, to the man who helped make this night happen, co-owner of the Miss Universe organization, the one and only Donald Trump.
The Donald.
And now, Tara Conner will take her final walk as the reigning Miss USA.
As I bid the title of Miss USA farewell, I know that one chapter of my life will come to an end, yet another is about to begin. When I was given a second chance by Mr. Trump, the door to recovery opened. Since then, I have learned that I truly can make a difference. More importantly, I received a great blessing, my sobriety. I am extremely grateful for the many experiences I had throughout my year. I enjoyed working with many great causes, and by the end of my reign, I championed a new cause, to raise awareness about the disease that once made my own life unmanageable. I want to sincerely thank Ms. Paula Schubart, my dear friends both at the Miss Universe organization and at the Karen Foundation, and to my family for believing in me. To Mr. Trump, you truly saved my life. I will forever be grateful. And above all, I want to thank God. To the new title holder, take in this experience for all that it has to offer. Thank you all for sharing this year with me.
And now, here are the official results signed off by Mark Ward of the accounting firm Ernst & Young. Thank you very much, Mark. Sharp suit.
All right, ladies, this is it. Come on over and join us right here. The fourth runner-up for Miss USA 2007 is Nevada.
The third runner-up is California.
The second runner-up is Kansas.
Okay, this is it. Ladies, please join us down here. Come and join us. This is the moment we've all been waiting for. How are you doing, ladies? We've got plenty of time.
Come on now, Tim.
If for any reason the new Miss USA cannot fulfill her duties, the first runner-up will take over. The first runner-up is Rhode Island. And so Miss USA 2007 is Tennessee. Well, that's it. Thank you very much to Hollywood and to the state of California, to Tara Conner, and to you, of course, Nancy O'Dell, and the little one.
Thank you very much, Tim. We will see you all at the 2007 Miss Universe Pageant in Mexico on NBC. Good night, everybody.
Hotel accommodations furnished by the Wilshire Grand Los Angeles Hotel. Wilshire Grand, close to perfection, and everything else. American Airlines offers 4,000 flights to 250 cities and 40 countries around the world every day. We know why you fly. We are American Airlines.